Mr. Beatty also explains very explicit how solicitors in Queensland are involved in some illegal land sale scams and how Japanese crime gangs are laundering money through real estate deals and through tourism facilities. I assume Mr. Beatty, who is in politics for donkey years, knows very well what criminal activities are going on behind closed doors and very much hidden away from the voters who have brought him and his brown noses into power and into a very lucrative income with lots of freebies and other goodies until to their death. In 1986, the Finn had allegedly $120,000 for his project. Everyone with a tiny bit of brain knows that this tiny sum of money does not build any service station with a commercial kitchen and an attached caravan park with 24 bays and an amenity building for 50 to 80 people. I also should mention here that this piece of land is not connected to any town water or any town sewage system. The building costs therefore must be clearly much higher than similar projects in towns or townships. Whenever I am thinking back what the Finn is doing 24/7 in his illegal residence and how his criminal backside is heavily padded from the local council, my little brain starts lighting up like the very huge Christmas tree at the Rockefeller Center in New York. The whole process, how the Finn's name suddenly has appeared on the land title, is very suspicious. The Finn himself has been unable to prove in court that he is the legal owner of this piece of dirt in the middle of nowhere and situated secluded enough away from the praying eyes of the law. By the way, the first lessees of the service station have bought the cattle farm which surrounds the Finn's land. The first lessees are not any Japanese, but good old Australian citizens, a vet and a district court judge. As you can see, these are highly educated people, and even they have not found out that they are trading illegally and with an illegal lease. But their little daughter has died at the northern entrance to the service station due to a school bus accident. I don't know if this accident happened because there is no proper lighting at the premises or due to other circumstances. During the town planning procedure in 1983, council has failed to invite any third parties to the almighty dance of knights. Only Main Roads has received this privilege, but Ergon Energy, Queensland Fire and Rescue Services, Environmental Protection Agency, Department of Natural Resources, State Emergency Services, and all the other third parties which are needed for such a development approval have been left in the dark. Documents show that the Main Roads part has miserably failed too.